I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
We talked about this.
Spit it out. Take that flip flop out of your mouth. Go, listen. You're a fan, Floyd Senior. I know you're a fan. You're a fan. I can see it in your eyes. You're a fan of my shit. I can see a fan when I fucking see one. You're a fan. Someone send him a signed autograph.
And you think, when you talk about half 40 and people who they ask why smoke, and you running up on me, I'm gonna beat this shit.
Ah, stuff, brilliant. Good man, Floyd, have a seat now.
Connor, 16 months ago, just down here. Connor, 16 months ago, we talked about this fight together one day, and it was talked about as potentially being a $1 billion fight, and it could still be that. Mm-hmm. Serious question. Obviously, you're going to go out there and deliver on August the 26th, and mm-hmm. if you beat Floyd, mm-hmm. you know, it will be massive for you, and potentially you may fight him again, we don't know. But how difficult or how easy will it be to go back to MMA afterwards? Because you are going to earn an extraordinary amount of money for this.
Woo-hoo-hoo! Say it again.
You're going to earn an extraordinary amount of
money. One more time.
An extraordinary amount of money.
Look, I love a true fight. Elbows, knees, shin bone, foot. You ever bounce a shin bone off a nose bone? You ever dug an elbow into the temple? It's an unusual feeling. It's an unusual feeling when the elbow bone digs into the temple. It's a nasty little one, but it's something that I just enjoy. It's something I love to do. So I look forward to going back to MMA and have a true fight after this. Maybe rematches and all will probably be in there, I'm sure. Look, we'll see. But I'm not forgetting my mixed martial arts training. I always focus on my kicking game. I always focus on my grappling. I always focus on my wrestling. I always throw folks on me. And then occasionally I do a little bit of boxing here and there.
Hey, what do you want to box me? Tomorrow?
Somebody's old has got to go. Oh, stop.
Do you want to box me tomorrow?
Stop.
Do you want to box me tomorrow?
Box you tomorrow?
Yes.
Box you tomorrow?
Yes.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. We're going to do it.
Do you want to have a fight? Do you want to put on the MMA gloves and have a knock?
I'm a real fight.
Shit out of you.
Right in front here.
How much have you got? How much have you got?
What
are you paying?
The microphone is on. You just gotta speak it.
Connor, you're fighting the number one boxer of this generation in his sport. So, should we use deductive reason and believe that you believe you can?
How about them for big Irish balls?
Let me ask the question. Do you believe you can beat every boxer that's 154 pounds and under?
Yes.
Connor, what did you say to Floyd when you guys were talking about
it, right? There was many exchanges. The main one was the gloves. So he was like, up on the stage, he was saying something, we can do 8 ounce, we can do 4 ounce. I was like, well, hold on. You were crying and their gloves had to be 10 ounce and they couldn't be gloves made from Mexico. They couldn't be Mexican made gloves. They couldn't be gloves made out of horsehair. I didn't even know there was gloves made out of horsehair. We're only wearing gloves a couple of years in their game. I don't even need gloves to have a fight. So it was all just amusing to me as it was going on. But he was talking up there like, we'll do 4 ounce, we'll do this, we'll do that. I was like, let's do it then. And then he was saying something about, I'll do MMA after. I'll fight you MMA after. I was like, look, don't be talking stuff you wouldn't do. We never step over into this game. So, but look, I'm enjoying myself. Like I said, it's a different plot. It's a different setup. Everything is just different. They didn't tell me nothing. They tried to kind of, you know, they kind of set me up a little bit, just rolled me out there. It's like, what? I was on the stage before I knew it. Standing on the stage for about 10 minutes. But look, I'm just embracing it, enjoying myself. I feel good. I look good. My company's name is on the poster. Life is so damn good and I'm blessed. I don't know, it's just a suit my tailor made. It says, fuck you on the pinstripe. It's pretty good, though. It's a good suit.
Who's that suit?
Everyone.
I was going to ask you about your suit.
What do you think is the biggest reason why people want to see this fight?
Sorry?
What do you think is the biggest reason why people want to see this fight?
Look, at the end of the day, I am fighting and he is boxing. It's two men at the top of their game, competing, and it's two worlds collide. So that enough is reason why this is what it is. Like I said on the stage, it's happened before. Muhammad Ali fought Antonio Inoki in Japan in the 60s under mixed rules, but he was actually misadvised. He was led to believe it was like a wrestling match. And then Antonio Inoki dropped to his back, which is a term called pulling guard in our sport. And he started kicking the legs off of Ali. And Ali was backing up and didn't really understand what was happening. So that was one incident where it happened, where a global, someone on the top reached out and done that. Another more documented was the James Toney, Randy Couture fight. James Toney from the same place Floyd is from. And the same outlook on MMA as a whole he has, as Floyd. They've spoke very badly about the sport multiple times. Only James Toney, fair play to him, he actually came over and tried to do something about it. He came and faced someone in our sport. Floyd didn't really want to do that, so, and he didn't really need to in the position he's in, so we wanted to come over and have boxing. So, let's...
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Ellie Sekpak.